Good evening, everybody. Good to see you back in the inside this afternoon. Thank you for staying with us. And I want to thank all the folks who brought food. It was great, as always. Had a bountiful plenty of food. It was all good. And I appreciate everybody that lent a hand for our meal today. All right, let's take a hymnal, turn to number 382. And I'll tell you what, I'm going to ask you to stand on the first one, then I'll let you sit on the second one. How about that? We sing better when we're standing anyway. Number 382. Brother James will pray for us this evening.
Father, your throne this morning, just praying, Lord, that you'd be with us as we struggle to live this life. Father, we need you in our lives. We pray, Lord, that you just come and be with us. I pray now, Lord, that you would be with our pastor as he goes in and out before us, Lord. Be with him and his family. Such an awesome job they have. And Father, we pray today that you'd give him the words that we need to hear today that would change our lives and make us draw closer to you. Father, thank you for the singing. We thank you, Lord, for all you do for us. We thank you for the food you gave us, the time you give us together to associate with each other, Lord. What a great God you are, Lord. We want to worship and pray and serve you for all things. I ask now that you'd be with those that's lost, especially those that we know as individuals. Lord, we pray that you just send someone that can touch them if we can ourselves. Father, thank you for being such a great God. We ask now that you'd forgive us of our sins. Give us a peace of mind that we could rest and hear the word of God preached. Forgive us where we fail. Thank you for sin. Jesus' sweet name I pray. Amen.
Amen. You may be seated. Now turn with me over to number 387. 387. Tim and I had talked, and he had asked me about one day having, on this Sunday, having Shepherd's Voice come and do a little mini concert. And I said, well, maybe today would be a good day since we moved the fifth Sunday to the fourth Sunday. And we just got through a revival where all of our singers sung specials. And I said, this might be an opportunity to just to do that. Shepherd's Voice is going to come and sing a few for you this afternoon before we turn it over to Brother Tim. Be a blessing to you.
Holy ground. Holy ground.
Coming a day when he shall say that time shall be no more, and I will have everlasting peace in a land that will never grow old. Can't you hear the angels sing? Can't you hear the welcome bells ring out? Can't you see the redeemed are called and plant their feet on holy ground? I see prophets of old all around God's throne and friends that have gone on. Dressed in robes of white, such a glorious sight. Oh Lord, how I want to go home.
Can't you hear
the angels sing? Can't you hear the welcome bells ring out? Can't you see the redeemed are called and plant their feet on holy ground? Can't you hear the angels sing? Can't you hear the welcome bells ring out? Can't you see the redeemed are called and plant their feet on holy ground? Plant your feet on holy ground.
Life is easy when you're up on the mountain and you've got peace of mind that you never know. But then things change and you're down in the valley. Don't lose faith, for you are never alone.
For the God on the mountain is still God in the valley. Things go wrong, He'll make them right. God of the good times is still God in the bad times, and God of the day is still God in the
talk comes so easy when life's at its best, but it's down in the valley of trials and temptations that's when faith is really put to the test.
For the God on the mountain is still God in the valley. Things go wrong, He'll make them right. And the God of the good times is still God in the bad times, and God of the day is still God in the night. For the God on the mountain is still God in the valley. Things go wrong, He'll make them right. In the lot of the good times. It's still God in the bad times and God of the day. It's still God in the night and God of the day. It's still God in the night.
Just a moment.
Okay.
Just stick one in each now.
Guy, can you put these mics in the monitor a little bit? Testing. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. Yeah. Yeah. Now I can hear everybody, I think.
Glad I'm so.
One day, old Elijah had some problems on the mountain. All alone, he stood against 400 prophets of Baal. He said, "Let the true God answer by fire up on the altar." When he prayed, the fire came down. You could hear Elijah yell. And I'm glad I'm serving a God who's able to deliver. I'm glad I'm serving a God who's able to defend. I'm glad I'm serving a God who hears me when I pray. I'm glad I'm serving a God on whom I can depend.
When my life is over and I'm standing in that city, gathered with the saints at the countless throne, someone might just ask me why I'm so happy. Just like Elijah, I can sing that same song.
I'm glad I'm a servant of God who is able to deliver. I'm glad I'm a servant of God who is able to defend. I'm glad I'm a servant of God who hears me when I pray. I'm glad I'm serving a God on whom I can depend. I'm glad I'm serving a God who is able to deliver. I'm glad I'm serving a God who's able to defend. I'm glad I'm a servant of God who hears me when I pray. I'm glad I'm serving a God on whom I can depend. I'm glad I'm serving a God on whom I can
glory land is not so far away, and we'll reach it some glad day. Heaven's home is now my final goal.
And what a
what a
be day, 'twill be
day, 'twill be.
And what a glory,
what a glorious
jubilee.
All of
heaven, all
of heaven
will be there.
What a meeting,
what a meeting in the
testing. Yeah, here we go. There we go. Here we go. I know, Brother James, this is just one of your favorites. I thought that number one would surely be me. I thought I would be what I wanted to be. I thought I would be on life's sinking sand, but I can't even walk without you holding my hand. I thought I could do a lot on my own. I thought I could make it all alone. I thought of myself as a mighty big man, but I can't even walk without you holding my hand. Lord, I can't even walk without you holding my hand. The mountains too high and the valleys too wide. Down on my knees, I learned to stand, 'cause I can't even walk without you holding my hand. Then one night I made Jesus my all and all. From then on, when I'm in trouble, on him I call. If I don't trust him, I'd be less than a man, 'cause I can't even walk without you holding my hand. Lord, I can't even walk without you holding my hand. The mountains too high and the valley down on my knees, I learned to stand, 'cause I can't even walk without you holding my hand. Without you holding my hand.
Amen. What's that? I heard the sound of a hammer upon the nail. I saw the pain
in his life, as if from grace he fell. I saw Mary as she knelt and watched in awe. As his crimson blood of life began to fall.
When he died,
he gave more than love for me. He did more than simply set the captive free. The pain of sin and strife. He gave more than love for me. He gave
I saw the stone that was covered was rolled away. Inside the tomb, it was empty where he had laid. I saw the scriptures be fulfilled, just like he'd said. But on the third day, he rose from the dead.
Simply set the captive free. More than take away the pain of sin and strife. He gave more than love. He gave life. He gave life.
We're going to do one more, Brother Tim. Close out with this one.
I was standing on the banks of the river, looking out over life's
troubled sea.
When I saw an old ship that was sailing, is that the
old ship of Zion I see?
It's hull was
bent and battered
from the storms of light
I could see.
Waves were
rough,
but that old ship
was steady.
Is that the
old ship of Zion I see?
At the stern of the ship
was the cat.
I could hear as he called out
my name.
Get on board, it's the old
ship of Zion.
It will never pass this way
as I step on board,
I'll be leaving
all my
sorrow and heartache behind.
I'll be standing with
Jesus the captain,
sailing
out on the old ship
of Zion.
Sailing
out on the old ship of
Zion. Amen. Good. Amen. Thank God. I'll put them up against anybody. Amen. Why, preacher? Because I know what they live. There's a lot of good singers out there. But I won't say a lot. There's a few. Let me redefine that. There's a few. But even among that few, there's a lot of them that don't live what they sing. I'm real picky when it comes to music and singers. And I'll put this group up against any of them. Thank you, Shepherd's Voice. We got some singing talent in this church, and I'm very thankful for it. Let me ask, how many of you that are here right now plan to be here for breakfast next week? Raise your hand if you're planning on being here for breakfast next week. Got that, Brother Jason? You counted them already? Okay. They'll probably, I don't know how many raised their hand, but I'd be safe to say we probably need to figure on 100. probably for next Sunday. That's so we can make sure we got ample food. If you got some good sausage you'd like to donate, or bacon, we'll be glad to take it. Or even eggs, I guess. Amen. We'd be glad to take that. That way, we don't have to buy it. If you've got a cow you want to donate, it ain't time to go turkey hunting, son. Get in here and sit down. Okay, all right. I want you to turn your Bible with me for a moment. We weren't trying to not sing anybody today. Both Cecil and I talked, and of course I've been wanting Shepherd's Voice to do some extended singing for us for some time. And he and I talked, and in view of the fact that we'd had revival and a lot of people had sang and stuff. And if you go out of here upset because you didn't sing, all I can tell you to do is get right with God. I appreciate all of you that sing. And I want to look at the passage of Scripture in the Bible. I'm going to be honest with you. We've had some specials that have been sang of late that raise concerns for me. It's raised some concerns in my heart. And I'm old school. I like old-fashioned music. I'm not into contemporary. You can get mad at me or whatever you want to get. I don't listen to it. What music I listen to is the kind of music that we sing here at the church. I want to caution us today to be careful about what we listen to. I want you to pay attention. I want you to be cautious about what you listen to. Because what you listen to influences what you sing. Okay? I don't listen to a lot of preaching on radio and television. I don't do that. There's some good ones out there. I don't even listen to myself preach. Why? Because I don't like how I sound. Well, we don't either. I'm sorry you voted me in. But I'm cautious even about preachers that I listen to, because that influences us. And the Bible makes that pretty clear in Ephesians chapter 5, that what we listen to influences what we sing. Be that privately in our own life. Now, I sing a good bit going up and down the road. I do. But I try to listen to that I know, number one, lines up with Scripture. And number two, it's not influenced by the world. Hello? See some of you curling up already. Ephesians chapter 5, verse 19. Here's the correlation of what we listen to as to what we sing. Speaking to yourselves in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs. There are a lot of stuff some of you listen to, and it ain't, you couldn't find an ounce of spirituality in it if you examined it with a microscope. Now, I know AFA is a real popular radio program. You're not going to hear much psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs on AFA. You're just not going to hear them. they're new, modern day, contemporary. Some of them fall all the way into the category of rock. Let me help us. There's no such thing as Christian rock. There's no such thing as Christian rap. And as a child of God, I'm gonna take it a little bit further. Most of what you hear in country and western, you can't find anything spiritual about it with a microscope. Now, I know I'm treading dangerously here, but I'm trying to help us. Because what you're listening to is influencing what you're singing. You listen to it, and then it becomes what this verse is talking about, speaking to yourselves in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs. That's what we're to be listening to, singing and making melody in your heart to the Lord. Now, let me just ask this honest question this evening. How much of this modern-day stuff that we hear today, that we're exposed to today, how much of that do you think Jesus would sit down and listen to? I see some of you. I ain't coming back here preaching. No, I'm trying to help us. Brother Cecil does a great job. And listen to me. Music is so important. And by nature, what you listen to is what you make melody in your heart about. Now, I'll be honest with you, When me and Miss Sandra met, I didn't listen to the right kind of music. I saved, but I didn't listen to the right kind of music. I listened to the Beach Boys. Anybody remember them? Boy, I was a Beach Boy fan. I liked them. The Temptations. Anybody remember them? Well, Brian, you ain't old enough to. That's horrible, preacher. Yeah, it was horrible. I didn't need to be listening to that. But that was mild. That was pretty calm compared to what. And listen to me, I'm talking about compared to what we hear flying under the banner of being Christian music today. Brother Mike Windham said, that preacher listened to the Beach Boys. But Mike Windham's still trying to process that. I even tried to sing some of it, Brother Mike. What are you laughing about, Kenji? You couldn't find the Beach Boys on the internet. But she probably could. Speaking to yourselves in songs, hymns, and spiritual songs. If we want our singing to be pleasing to the Lord, the melody that we make in our heart, what we allow to go in our ears, must fall within those three definitions of music. Why just those three? Because it's Bible. Because it's Bible. That's why. Is the Bible our guidebook? Is it our instruction booklet? I believe it is. And I believe when we listen to what the Bible prescribes, the book of Ephesians, songs, hymns, and spiritual songs, then the melody we make in our hearts is going to be what we want to get up and sing in the presence of others. Amen. I'm not fussing. I'm just, as your pastor, I've had some concerns about some of the music, particularly in the realm of specials that we've had. Okay? And as your pastor, it's part of my responsibility to help bring that back into what I believe is the guidelines of the Scripture. Now, you can get mad and blow up and get out and talk about me if you want to, but it's going to be on you because I'm certainly not saying what I'm saying to hurt or offend anybody. And if you think I do that, you don't know my heart. Because that's not my intent. I want to encourage you. But I want our music to honor the Lord. I don't want outsiders coming into this church and hearing music that they could hear out on the streets. Hear it up the road or down the road or around the road at a contemporary church. I don't want them coming in here and hearing that kind of music because that's not the kind of church we want to be. Well, that's the kind of church I want to be. Yeah. You don't have to run me off. And I guess you could. Songs, hymns, spiritual songs. Those psalms are written in our Bible. You do realize the book of Psalms is a song book, right? It is actually a song book. And the children of Israel often sang from those psalms. There's folks that knows how to put music to those. Boy, there's something. They speak to you. So I guess probably need to have prayer and go to the house. Some of you ain't like what I said. I'm just trying to help our church. I want us to stay online, stay right with our music. Trying to help my song leader. He and I discussed it several times. Be careful. I'm telling you. I ain't got to listen to you but just a couple of times, and I know what you're listening to. I know what you're listening to. You know why? Because that's what you're singing in your heart, making melody, you think, to the Lord. And then when your opportunity comes to sing, you sing it here. And it's because that's what you're listening to. Let's keep it where it honors Him. You're not going to line up right. Like I say, I'm old school. I'm old fashioned. I like the hymn books. I like the songs we sing out of the hymn books. I like to hear people sing them old hymns. How many of you today know I love you? Raise your hand. Preacher, I know you love me. Raise them again. All right. As long as you know, I love you. My intent's not to hurt you. My intent's for everything that we do here, that it'll bring honor to the Lord. Okay? Be careful about what you listen to. And I'm not just talking about music. Be careful about who you listen to preach. Everybody calls itself a preacher. The Bible's got a classification that the Bible uses. One of them is false prophets. There are plenty of them out there. And then he uses another classification of a hireling. They're in it for the money. They're in it for what they can gain. Not just monetarily, but power and prestige and all of that. Find preachers that are preaching because you feel in your spirit, God testifies in your spirit, they're preaching the truth and they're preaching it because their motivation's right. Be careful who you read behind. There's a lot of books being written today. I don't read them, but I may read an excerpt from one. I may, but they'll look at a portion of one somewhere. Somebody may ask me about a book, and I'll go examine it. And I'm telling you, there's some crazy stuff out there today. And just because a man or a woman writes it and professes to be a Christian, don't mean it's good for you. Be careful. We sing a song, or the kids sing a little song. Be careful, little eyes, what you see. Be careful, little ears, what you hear. Be careful, little feet, where you go. Be careful, little hands. That probably ain't all of it, that's all I remember. Be careful, little mouth, what you say. Thank you, Sister Sherry. Good instruction. We good? Say, if you go out here mad at me, we'll. I pray God with you. Amen. Because I'm certainly not. And if you got something to say about what I said, don't go to Brother Cecil. You hear me? Don't go to Brother Cecil. Brother Cecil didn't know I was going to address this today. But he and I have talked about it and prayed about it. Y'all do it when the whole church is full. I may do it. Be careful. We want what we do here to honor him. No matter what it is, we want it to honor him. Don't go to my wife. Don't go to the deacons. Even though they come tell me. If you got issues with it, you come talk to me and I'll put my arms around you and pray for you and love on you. I will. But I want us to do right. It's important. Our music is important. Amen. Our music's important. Let's keep it within the bounds of psalms, hymns, spiritual songs. Amen? All right. Stand to our feet. See you Wednesday night. I hope you'll...